there are two types of intraangular echogenic figures. Here we see the right lobe. This nodule has a characteristic dorsal acoustic shadow. I go back to this nodule. This is mainly a peripheral type macro or coarse calcification. So at the periphery we can see this disruption of the coarsely calcified focus can be interpreted as a bit suspicious sign, but in the everyday practice the various forms of macro calcifications have very limited importance in my view. The main problem is that from such a nodule it is quite difficult to gain cytological material. If we cross the coarsely calcified focus, we cannot gain, or not infrequently, we cannot gain enough material because the calcification closes the duct of the needle. In such nodules, we can guide aspiration cytology from this angle, where the nodule lacks this coarsely calcified focus. So the main issue in RIM calcification is that it is very difficult to gain material, and the other, that the dorsal acoustic shadow hinders the judgment of the nodule. We cannot state anything about this part of the nodule, whether it is hypocogenic, does it have microcalcification. So we did not see the tissue located dorsal to the coarsely calcified focus. Now we go forward. The left nodule has a large cystic lesion. The amount of cystic fluid is almost equal to the solid part, so this can be interpreted either as a dominantly solid or a dominantly cystic nodule. Most of the intranodular echogenic lines are clearly related to ventral cystic area, so this form and also this one and this one and also this are backwall figures. Here is only a tiny cystic area of ventral to this echogenic line. Here is a much larger. The issue is how to interpret these figures within the solid part. On thorough analysis, we can see that most of these lines have also cystic areas ventral to these granules or lines. Nevertheless, the entire impression is not fully reassuring. I think that it is worse to target this part of the nodule gaining cytological material. Now the video demonstrates the removal of 8 milliliter cystic fluid. It was removed by 2 attempts. Here I raise your attention to this part of the lesion, which we will see corresponds to the just refilling part of the nodule. The second part of the aspiration, I stopped the video. Okay, if I had two choice to state that this is a microcalcification or this is not a microcalcification, I clearly stated that these figures are not microcalcifications, but I am not fully sure about this. So I think that this part of the nodule, this solid part, is a candidate for aspiration cytology. Okay, very probable, very likely that these are backfall figures, but it is not a clear-cut situation. Go forward with the video. So this is the second phase of aspiration. And now, after the aspiration, we can see this cloudy mass, which corresponds to the refilling of the nodule. The removal of the cystic fluid has tamponaded the vessel, and after the relief of this tamponade, the vessels started to refill the nodules. So these are this structure corresponds to flesh blood. It is not a very rare situation, but we did not find this in every orders. Several percent, 1 to 5% of mainly large cysts refill just after the removal of the cystic fluid. So this is a very characteristic sign. And again, back to our topic. Echogenic granule or line, ventral to this, to these lines, there is tiny cystic area. Here we can see again. Here it is not evident whether this is located just dorsal to cystic areas. And regarding these figures, we most of these figures lack this ventral cystic area. Nevertheless, it is a reasonable assumption that these are also located dorsal to cystic areas, but such tiny cystic areas which cannot be projected in the ultrasound video. So I think that this part of the nodule should be aspirated, and this is the form of the backfall figure which is not clearly distinct from a microcalcification. So this was our second case.